Since Nostradamus' death, a lot of people have always talked about some of his predictions and always talked about some of the things he said would happen. There are some obvious glaring issues with people who think he was some kind of fortune teller, but it's also worth noting that some of those predictions have actually come true. Ready to join the finest squad? Then make sure to subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss any of our interesting videos ever again. That being said, let's begin. Nostradamus helped combat the plague. One of the earliest acts that helped him gain so much fame is that he actually helped combat the plague when it was ravaging most of Europe. A lot of people didn't quite understand the plague, and doctors at the time had absolutely no clue how to deal with it. This became evident by some of their very flawed treatment methods. Some of their questionable methods were only the result of not having any kind of medicine to treat a disease they didn't understand, and a lot of the population was dropping dead like flies. They were starting to wrap people up in garlic-covered robes because they thought it would help them ward off the infection, but it had no effect. Nostradamus started to travel around Europe and began teaching people to eat healthy. He also tried to stress the importance of having proper hygiene and keeping yourself clean. He also proposed moving the dead bodies out of the street so that more airborne illnesses wouldn't spread throughout all of the cities. He actually cured and helped a lot of people through these simple steps. Nostradamus, the cult leader. Around 1538, there were some charges that started to spring up against Nostradamus because of some of his scribblings that he was leading a cult or planning to start an occult. These charges were obviously bogus, so Nostradamus did what most people would do. He simply left and started traveling through Europe before he was ordered to appear before the Church Inquisition, where he would have likely faced dire consequences if he were found guilty. When he was out traveling and going through different areas of Europe, this is when people believed he started to have a psychic or spiritual experience that awakened him. Some people who believe in a more hardcore theory believe he was abducted by or at least visited by aliens who gave him some insight into the Earth, what to expect, and when the Earth will end. One of his first ever predictions came as he met a group of Franciscan monks while traveling in Italy. He predicted that Felice Peretti would become the next pope, and this was his first accurate prediction. Pope Sixtus V was ordained in 1585. When the prophecies began. Some say that the prophecies started to truly take shape in 1554. It's unknown just how many prophecies Nostradamus had predicted, but when he began this project, he wanted to write 10 different volumes, which would have 100 prophecies in them. He had foreseen 2,000 years into the future and wanted humanity to know what he knew. He wanted everyone to see what he had seen, and there's still no clue as to what had awakened these predictions in him. Since he could be prosecuted for these predictions, he decided to cleverly disguise them by putting them in poem form. Not only that, but he wrote them in several languages so that the local province could only understand a handful of them. If there's one thing no one can deny, it's that Nostradamus was an incredibly smart person. He never had to worry about persecution from the Roman Catholic Church because he had an incredibly good relationship with them. He never faced persecution from anyone because he never delved into the magic and arts of the prophecies. He was very careful to never include those. How do you think Nostradamus was able to predict so many things happening in such a short span of time? Luck? The death of Nostradamus. While Nostradamus was writing, he was in a constant state of writing. If he wasn't traveling, he wasn't writing down prophecies and things he has seen in the future. So it's no surprise that he suffered with arthritis for most of his life, and that's even something a lot of people today suffer. So many people spend so much of their time on the keyboard that they also suffer from arthritis-like conditions. He also was known to suffer from gout, which wasn't easily treatable at the time, and it's something you just had to suffer through. However, in his late life, he began to form edema and dropsy. This condition today is easily treatable and usually doesn't cause any physical harm to people, but back then, there was no cure for it, and the diet of people back then was less than ideal. As the condition progressed, he was then diagnosed with congestive heart failure. His last ever prophecy was a letter written to his wife, which simply said, "You will not find me alive at sunrise," and he was found dead next to his bed in the morning. The Nostradamus predictions for 2019 are here. Nostradamus has always been a figure that people who believe in astrology look back to. They think that the ramblings of this man are fact, and some people even believe that he had help from aliens who visited Earth and could look into the future. We don't want to be naysayers here, but we also want to point out that this guy spent most of his life just scribbling down various predictions. Isn't it possible that out of the thousands of predictions that he wrote down during his life, some of them were bound to come true? Or do you think maybe that people are reaching way too far to try to find some truth into the things he's said and done? It's obvious that Nostradamus is a well-respected figure in astrology, and a lot of people regard him as one of the best fortune tellers of all time. A lot of people think he predicted 9/11 when the Twin Towers fell, and a lot of people think he knows when humanity on Earth would actually end. Are we calling him a liar? Well, absolutely not. It's plausible that an outside spiritual force guided his predictions, but we can't help but wonder, since he made so many predictions, weren't some of them bound to happen in one form or another? The London Fire. It was known as the Great Fire of London, and it was one of the most historical fires in the world, burning much of what was once London to the ground. It was rumored that Nostradamus actually predicted the time and the date that London would catch on fire. This one may seem like a bit of a reach, but the main components of the prediction were 20, 60, and 6. People think that because all the numbers added up to 1666, this surely had to be the prediction. The three-day inferno which burned most of London began on September 2nd. One of the predictions was that lightning would start the fire, but like most catastrophic fires, they're usually man-made or accidental. The fire accidentally started by a spark in a bakery, and from that tiny little spark, an inferno roared throughout London. Did Nostradamus predict Hitler? One famous Nostradamus prediction that a lot of people like to reference is that he predicted Adolf Hitler's rise to power and the Nazi army. He said that a poor child would be born in Germany, he would rise to power, and he would enthrall people into a frenzy. There would be a bloodbath and, well, most of that was correct. However, Hitler was not born into a poor home or a poor family. Hitler was actually born in Austria to a relatively middle-class family, and they never had to struggle. Hitler did in fact rise to power with the use of his tongue, because if there's one thing Hitler excelled at, it was enthralling people to fight for him. He did in fact start a bloodbath and a war when he decided to invade Poland for reasons that are probably only known to him. Americans bombing Japan. Japan and the USA used to have a very rocky relationship. One fateful morning, Japan decided to bomb Pearl Harbor, and we'll never exactly know why they decided to do that. It may have been a preemptive strike because they wanted to try and cripple the military's naval defense capabilities so that they could plan another attack, or they could prevent the US from retaliating. However, the USA wasn't gonna go down like that and began mapping out a counterattack. Some brave pilots had to strip most of their airplanes of non-essential things so that they could make the long journey and carry the bombs. Then, on the early evening of August 1945, the United States didn't just bomb them, they dropped two atomic bombs on Japan. One of them went off within Hiroshima, and one of them landed in Nagasaki. This was not only a retaliation, but it completely crippled Japan. There was even a food shortage after, and we honestly think this one was a bit of a stretch to say Nostradamus can take credit for it. The 1980s dilemma. In France, a revolution of sorts was started. In 1983, some top-level professors and experts began examining a lot of Nostradamus' work and his private correspondence with other people. What they found was rather fascinating, because as they began cross-examining the facts with a lot of his early work, they discovered that a lot of the material didn't exactly fit the facts to scope. It's also revealed that while there were a lot of claims in the original works, not a single one of them was backed up by any facts that they could find. There was not one piece of documentary evidence. This was another main problem with Nostradamus' predictions, because a lot of these predictions couldn't be proven that they were even made by Nostradamus. How much do we really even know about Nostradamus, and how many of his claims were originally from him? The main problem with Nostradamus' prophecies. In order to avoid the persecution that he was constantly under threat of, with some people claiming that he was a witch, he was constantly writing down prophecies, and he was constantly writing in a language that most people couldn't read. Some of the texts he's written are poorly worded and poorly written altogether. There's no way to decipher some of the texts he's written over the years, and some people think that others are just reaching to try to make sense of his writings. It's easy to interpret whatever you want to believe and try to make a modern-day event out to be some kind of revelation by him. For example, when he mentioned the fiery twin towers in the sky in one prophecy, people were quick to jump to the twin towers in 2001. People thought this surely had to be a Nostradamus prediction, but this could have meant anything. He's also had a lot of prophecies that never came true as of yet, so we could easily just take a future event, look back at some of his incoherent writings, and say that he predicted such an event. Do you really think Nostradamus could predict the future? Do you think there was any truth to the madman's methods, or is this just some giant fairy tale? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.